Adversaries, I will ferry to cemeteries, then I'll bury my arrival. Rap survival, co-defending the title. Assassinator, resuscitator, star invader of the late great King Crusader.
YouTube, salute. We about to get into this Too Surf and Joe Budden's conversation. There's a conversation between Surf and Joe who are extremely close with each other and they're venting about their life problems. Let's check this out right here.
Constantly accomplishing all of these new accomplishments. Sometimes I wake up and feel like I ain't really accomplished shit. Honestly, a stressful thoughts as random as this bitch that I'm next to. I know this conversation probably like pot the kettle. I need your opinion. I could possibly be tripping. My conclusions all the same. It'd be like fuck it or smithing. I need logic. I got skeletons in my closet. Won't say I'm trying to clean it up. Just sort it out. Sharing with you shit that I thought about. Who can't stop dreaming about Joe? How I get these demons out? Voices in my head. I need this screaming out. Man, I did bad things. I ain't proud and I ain't glad things. They was trying to press me, I gave them joy and that's mad rings. Bunch of shit, tell me how you think I should handle it or manage it. Fuck, I wasn't ready for this camera shit and grammar sick. God damn it, grammar sick. Fuck, I'm probably rambling shit. Here I go rambling.
Okay, so now Surf, he's going in. He's having these dreams, nightmares, and he don't know how to get these demons out of his head. And like he's saying, I need logic. I got skeletons in my closet. So he has a lot of things he wants to actually bring out of his, in the inside to the outside. You know, he did bad things in life and he don't know who to talk to. He don't know who to trust. So now Joe Budden's getting ready to actually talk to him. So this year, so Joe Budden's gotta say.
Something gotta give with it. You don't get rid of your demons. You learn to live with it. 4/5 in a capsule. Painkillers for them nights that you get sick with it. Blinders over your eyes, my nigga. Shit vivid. Get livid. Shit twisted. It'll happen like a bad disaster. A nigga see you like a battle rapper. But you your own worst enemy. So once you leave smack, you have to have a real battle after.
Okay, so you heard what Joe said. Joe said, you don't get rid of your demons. You got to learn to live with them. You got to learn how to actually say, it happened. I accept that and move forward. Blinders over your eyes, my nigga. Shit's vivid. So it's real out here. And niggas see you like a battle rapper, but you your own worst enemy. I always was taught that by my godmother, priestess. You can be your greatest ally or your worst enemy. That's some real shit.
I lost 3 homies in like 4 weeks. Same place I call home, nothing about North Sweet. And I don't keep it on me just so I can hold heat. I keep it cause the reaper land niggas in these cold streets. If I go, how my daughter gonna eat? Who gonna tell her right from wrong? How my mama gonna sleep? Sheesh. They say when you speak it, you bring it in the flesh. Few my niggas left, and I'm feeling like a nigga
my
next.
Nigga, stop it. You got time on your side like that Glock is. That paranoia got you obnoxious. Let me paint an angle. You ain't lose friends, you gain angels. So before bed, you should be saying thank you. And oh, far as you see, just be there and stay put. I only see mine on my baby mother Facebook. You got a hand in rap and one in the streets. Gotta be faithful to one when them two sides meet.
All right, y'all. So let's go back. So Surf is just saying that how he's going to feed his daughter. He has to have the gun on him. He don't know what he's going to do because it's hard out here in these streets. And Joe Budden says, stop it. Even though you got this Glock on you, you need to understand that your friends that died, they're not here physically, but they're with you spiritually. They're your guardian angel. They're your ancestors now. They will protect you. Speak their name. They're right there to listen to you. And you got a hand in a rap and one hand in the streets. So one hand, you got 1 foot in the rap game, 1 foot in the streets. You got to be faithful when these two sides meet. So you got to, you know, pick a side at the end of the day.
Real. And me and my baby mama tried to work it out again. Same results, was just running her mouth again. push me away. I won't lie, I dipped out again. Here I go trying to freshly paint an old house again. Do they always leave with more than they came with? Text you like they changed, turn around and be the same bitch. Man, I need answers, Joe. I need answers. Look,
get you some shit to roll, a little cancer. Get you some stacks of ones, couple dancers. They'll make you king for a night, or maybe chancellor. She'll think you still in the hood, standing on chancellor. Baby mom's wild whenever they get the chance to. Useless arguments, I never been a fan of. That's 18 years of dealing with the banter. Restraining order, she'll violate if you don't ban her. That's payback for all the bullshit she think you handle.
Okay, now Surf, he's talking about me and my baby mama try to work it out, even work it out. You know, he's having his little problems. So Joe was trying to tell him, look, get you some shit, roll a little cancer. Baby mama's wild whenever they get a chance. That's 18 years of dealing with the banner. The banter, excuse me. But he's trying to say that it's 18 years of shit that you're going to have to deal with. You can't control that. You're just going to have to just roll with the punches, man. Keep going.
Well, Tylenol bottles full of Xans, couple hundreds, couple bitches now, I guess I got plans, man. Can't let her get the best of me. First she said fucking, now she paragraph texting me. I'm the reason we like this, well allegedly. Thoughts all scrambled, other bitches keep egging me. Bugging out, fall asleep, creeping, turn to breakfast at another house. Wild sex with bitches that barely get a number out. Always start with a chill before the sex, before the feelings, before shit get real, for real. I felt like I ain't need her. Felt shit change and start confiding in Carisha. Shit, swear it was something I ain't mean to do. And stop giving a fuck when I found out she cheated too. Unbelievable, who could have guessed a nigga stressing, saying F it. Rebounds turned into a new possession, it's getting hectic.
Okay, so Surf said that, you know, he found out his baby mama cheated on him. And those rebounds made him a better person. It hurt at first. You know, just like, who wants to be cheated on at the end of the day? That's some hurtful shit. Joe's getting ready to give him some advice.
New possession, same shot clock. Funny, wherever I go, them same thoughts watch. We in VIP unscrewing, playing some rock top. So she'll think I jumped for the box, playing hopscotch. But I can't give you girl advice. Not when I used to use girls as advice. Shit, sex was a drug, the orgasm was a high on its own, ma'am. Knew they was addicted, they never got with the program. Or was it codependency? In reverse, did I need them to depend on me? Showing unconditional love, no contingencies. Though I knew it wouldn't last, I pretend it could be. My aura never came off as apprehensive, at least. So if you're listening, please don't take this offensively. It wasn't meant to be. You took a ride with the devil, Jekyll and Hyde. Makes sense that I was hiding Jekyll. They couldn't take it any longer from me. So it's odd they all moved around the corner from me. Maybe they hoping we'll run into each other. That'll ruin you. Sort of like a car to a dead. That's what y'all are to me, my dear. Do y'all sleep better knowing that a part of me is near? But I'm so out of love, you got a part, and if I care, I swear. If this takes things from this space, I think the love is lost. They think it's misplaced.
Okay, so Joe said, I can't give you advice on women when I was using women before, but I gotta let you know that the women gonna always watch when you moving forward. So that's how it is. You gotta show unconditional love, no contingency. You know, It's a Jekyll and Hyde. It's a good and evil situation what you're dealing with out here in life. That's what he's trying to tell him. So Surf goes in. Oh.
Suddenly every bitch got time. When I'm back home, I be feeling like LeBron. They say you made it. I'm just thinking in my mind like I ain't made it till I made a safe haven for my mom. I think I fucked up too many times. Don't think she fully understand the whole grind. I wonder if Alana know why daddy go. She can't get Doc McStuffins and daddy broke.
I've been there playing a role, couldn't take it. They told me you gotta fake it till you make it. Against my will, I really tried to embrace it. And then I transformed into everything that I hated. I always picture me spinning bank in the district. Then I learned you get famous before you get rich. They'll think you ballin'. You might have to bounce on dudes capping your money you thought that you could count on.
Okay, so Surf said that, you know, people thought he made it because they thought he was treating him like LeBron James, but he didn't make it. He don't feel like he made it till his mom is gonna actually have what she needs to have. Joe's saying, I've been there playing that role. They told me you gotta fake it just to make it, but he felt like, fuck that, I'm going against my own will. Always picture me spending bank in the district, and they'll think you balling, you might have to bounce on dudes counting your money. Yo, thought you could count on. So people only worry about how much money you got. They don't even give a fuck about you going.
Call my phone trying to book me for a fucking battle. I'm still having battles of my own. Some battles I don't feel strong enough to win. Even if I did, I rarely win them battles with Patron. So pessimistic, I need to stop it. This shit ain't easy. Alana called me yelling, "Daddy, I see you on TV." Why I be feeling stuck in shit? Like this money ain't cutting it.
Different stages, different phases, different animals, different cages, different charges, that's different cases. Been the same me all along with different aces. Aim up, different cops kill different faces. It end different, wish it was happening in different races. Different decade, can't tell we in different ages. Same gang, same result, just different places.
Okay, okay, so Surf says that, you know, they trying to book him for battle. He's still having battles of his own. He's battling drinking alcohol. And he has, you know, his daughter tell him that she sees him on TV. And Joe Budden is letting him know that it's different stages, different phases, different animals, different cages. So everything's different, but it's still the same shit you're dealing with. Every month is always different cops, different faces. It's the same shit we've seen, but it's just different characters what we see all the time. Going.
Separate my wants from my needs. Mom said I'm like my pops. Had apple don't fall far from the tree. I couldn't quote her. If it was anything like me, we would definitely be closer. But she kinda got a point. Man, I need to roll another joint. So much come with that pop shit. You ever confronted that pop shit? Different if we was closer. I hate it, but I chuck it up. I was in the streets, a lost cause, I probably fucked it up. I was younger though, that was just a lesson he left from when he really needed protection. Say he and him, I hate saying us. Late nights, I was staying up, waiting. Fell asleep thinking I hate him. Cold hearted, cause I gotta be. He ain't have to lie to me. Man, why this shit even still bother me?
Okay, so Surf saying that you ain't fall from the apple, if the apple ain't fall far from the tree. So just saying that he's talking about mom say just like his father. So he feels that he was in the streets and it fucked him up and he needed, you know, protect himself. So that's how he actually has his cold heart now. Now Joe finishes off.
But we all been fatherless. Word. At 13, word. I thought mine ain't wanna be bothered with. But life come at you fast. Buckle up or get buckled, they'll be harder hits. Learn to guard your shit regardless of what is. Far as demons, gotta live with monsters at the crib. I got experience, you need a nigga, holla at the kid. And I tell you how to grow up better than myself. Just some lessons that nobody knows better than myself. It's Joe. Joe. You know what I mean?
Okay, so Joe tells him we all are fatherless children. And at the end of the day, he's been there and done that. And if you need somebody to talk to, he will actually open his arms up to him. You know what I'm saying? Let him know that I empathize with you and I can be there to support you, man. Don't worry about that. We've all been there. I might not have the same struggle, but I'm here to talk to you about that so I can actually help you cope with this situation.
Oh, hope you was able to pull something away from this conversation, my nigga.
Wow, what up?
Fucking the Lord, bitch. Keep that gun
cocked. Okay, that's the end of the song. First and foremost, the beat is nice. Whoever did the production did a great job. I love the back and back dialogue. It's great. It's great. I love the fact that somebody's opening up and telling them, you know, about the problems they're dealing with. You know, your baby mama, child, your fame, your stardom, depression, not having your father there. You know, feeling like you need to do more, having this, living in two different worlds, the streets and you know, celebrity status. And you got Joe Budden's actually playing not just devil's advocate, but actually kind of give him this sense of, hey, man, calm down, calm down. I'm going to tell you some things that people ain't going to tell you. I'm going to keep it real. I'm going to give you tough love. But at the same time, I'm going to give you a hug like a big brother. I think that was a beautiful, dope ass track. I'm surprised I never heard this track before. Damn, I'm sleeping. But I'm glad somebody told me about this track. So shout out to Diggy. Salute. Post your comments below. Hulk smash Black Panther the like button. Subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon to be notified when I upload new content and go live. If you'd like to support the channel, I have Patreon, Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, Streamlabs, everything's in the description. Until next time, peace.